And we're back, and this time I'll give you a short introduction to the rule of thirds in photography. The rule of thirds is a simple helping tool to compose your images, and you should see it as a guideline and less of a rule to always abide to. You can always break it. Let me show you in principle what it looks like. So we've got this canvas size. It's a typical size for YouTube videos, so 1920x1080. And if you divide that by 3, you've got 640x360. And this gives you 9 compartments. And that creates this rule of thirds, where we've got these intersections. So 4 of them. And when you have a different format like this, it switches. In this example, the height is bigger than the width. And here the width, it was bigger than the height. So how is it now applied? Let us look at some examples. You'll find all of these images via the description links below. And in Photoshop, you've got your cropping tool, and you can use the rule of thirds as a grid. So right click on this icon, make sure it's checked. And if I now apply a crop, you can see we've got our rule of thirds with the intersections automatically created. And you want to put, when you apply to the rule of thirds, the most prominent element of your image onto an intersection, because this is where our eyes are naturally drawn to. Another way to use it is to use the horizontal lines to position the horizon in the image. For example, here, the sea level, and it would be perfect if we had the mountain level up here. So it's a question of taking the photo, and most cameras have the option to blend in a rule of thirds grid as well, and you should use that as a helping tool, as I've said. Let us take a look at the next example, which is this one. And you can see this breaks with the rule of thirds in its original, as the ship is positioned exactly in the center. We blend in, crop, and I could now position it just like this. I could make sure to place the sea level on a horizontal line, but the results aren't as good as the original. If we compare that, I just like it when the ship is in the center. So, as I've said, use the rule of thirds as a guideline and not as a rule to always abide to. When you have portraits, you want to place the eyes on the horizontal level and the shoulders on the bottom horizontal line. So in this example, the head is a little bit tilted. Let us look at another example, and here you can see the eyes are perfectly positioned. The shoulders are somewhat on the lower horizontal line. And sometimes it looks best if you place the eyes exactly on the intersections on the top horizontal line. And that's it. This was the short introduction to the rule of thirds in photography. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.